Hi, welcome to this video where we're going to talk all about 2.5-axis machining. The first thing you're probably thinking is, what is 2.5-axis machining? And you can see in SolidWorks, I've made myself 4 viewports to hopefully try and explain this really easy. In the top left, we can see we've got a part with a coordinate system. X is red, Y is green, and the blue is Z. And what 2.5-axis machining means is that we can go in 2 of those axes simultaneously at a third depth. So a great example for this, in most milling machines, you move in X and Y at a Z depth, and that gives you 2.5-axis machining. Another thing that you have to consider with 2.5-axis machining is that if we go to the front view, in the front view, I can look top down and see all my geometry. There's no slopes, no angles. And this is another criteria that we must hit for 2.5-axis machining. We must be able to look top down on the part, or as you can see in the bottom here, on the side view, and have no tapers. There is one exception to this, and you can see the part has got one chamfer around the outside. Chamfers are completely fine, because we can use what's called a contour operation, where we pick the line, and it's the tool that actually makes the shape. So with all that being said, let's have a look at what it looks like for machining in 2.5D. I've got a SolidWorks cam part already set up here, and let's go into a single view so we can see the machining in action. I'm going to go to simulate my toolpath and slow the speed right down so we can see exactly what's going off. The first operation is a facing operation, and you can see that takes out the edge, and then we're just going to rough out the corners just to make sure we can do one cut round the outside to finish off. But you can see all the time it's doing X and Y moves and going down a Z depth at a time. So that is the quintessential way a 2.5-axis toolpath works. You can see here we've got a new strategy called a pocket, and that again is going and doing similar strategies to what you've seen before, always using the X and Y. Third one here is on an open pocket or a slot, and you can see that's working backward and forward completely fine because we're using X and Y and then going down to a Z depth each time to finish off. And then after this, what we will do is look at the drilling again, 2.5-axis, even though we're only doing one position and drilling down. And you can see there we're just finishing off the counter bores. And as a final operation, we'll look at the chamfer, and you can see that it just wipes through exactly as we said before. It's a tool actually that's making the shape rather than the toolpath. So with all that being said, I hope you've enjoyed this, and thanks for stopping by.